एवरीवन, आई एम मिसेस ज्योत्सना मीणा एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द बिजनेस स्टडी क्लास 12 सेकंड चैप्टर प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ मैनेजमेंट एंड द टॉपिक इज साइंटिफिक मैनेजमेंट. दिस इज द वीडियो नंबर 10 एंड इन दिस वीडियो द साइंटिफिक मैनेजमेंट एंड इट्स इम्पॉर्टेंस इज एक्सप्लेन्ड. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, वॉट इज साइंटिफिक मैनेजमेंट? साइंटिफिक मैनेजमेंट इज द आर्ट ऑफ नोइंग एग्जैक्टली वॉट यू वॉन्ट मैन टू डू एंड सीइंग दैट दे डू इट इन बेस्ट एंड चीपेस्ट वे. दिस इज द डेफिनेशन गिवन बाय एफ डब्ल्यू टेलर. बट इन जनरल वर्ड्स वी कैन ऑल्सो से दैट साइंटिफिक मैनेजमेंट इज द वर्क ऑफ मैनेजमेंट विच इज डन इन अ साइंटिफिक वे और इन अ सिस्टमैटिक वे विच इज बेस्ड ऑन द कॉज एंड इफेक्ट रिलेशनशिप एंड इट इज बेस्ड ऑन अ फ्यू प्रिंसिपल्स. Or we can say that when the activities of management are done in a scientific way, it is called scientific management. Now, what is the importance of scientific management? Let us see importance of scientific management. First of all, increase in efficiency. Scientific management is helpful in increasing the efficiency of the workers and managers. By which process? It is helpful in increasing the efficiency because the workers are controlled in a systematic way. A number of work studies are made on them and the different type of with the help of different work study like time study, motion study, method study, fatigue study, the workers can we can use the work power or manpower at its maximum capacity, or we can increase their efficiency, and within less time and within minimum movements we can get the maximum efficiency from the workers. Second is effective control. The scientific management is based on the principle of functional foremanship. Functional foremanship means different type of controls are made on the worker. There are 8 type of control made on a single worker. The control is made not only by a single person, but there are different bosses on a single worker. Just like gang boss, speed boss, time boss, etc., which controls different type of activities of the worker. Like time and cost clerk watches the time taken by worker, speed boss watches the speed of the worker, disciplinarian puts a control on the discipline. In this way there are different type of 8 type of persons who control the worker, and in this way we can get the effective control on the worker. Then next one is maximum production at minimum cost. By the scientific management, the wastage is minimized. By minimum wastage of time, minimum wastage of material, minimum wastage of money or work powers efficiency, we can get the maximum production from the workers. We can use the products, materials, things, time and manpower in their maximum capacity. So maximum production can be possible from the workers, and in the same way the wastage is avoided, the minimum wastage is there, so the cost of the product goes to its minimum because maximum output can be gained in minimum time and minimum cost. Next one is best use of resources. There are different type of resources, just like the human resources, physical resources, etc. And by this type, different type of resources, human resources means manpower, workers, etc. Physical resources like different type of machines, material, money, the methods used in the work, etc. So all of these resources means man, machine, material, money, etc. are used at its maximum level. The wastage of all of them are avoided and they are used at their maximum capacity or utmost capacity with the help of scientific management. because the different type of experiments are made, different type of studies are made on the workers, like time study, motion study, method study, different type of controls are put on the worker. In this way, we can use the manpower and the material, money, etc. at its best capacity. In this way, best use of resources is possible in scientific management. And last one is incentive waste system. This point is also explained in the characteristics of scientific management. As you know, incentive waste system, incentive means inspirative. This is the type of wages in which a efficient worker or hardworking worker is paid at higher rate of wages, and the worker of lower capacity or lower efficiency is paid the wages at lower rate. Means the wages are paid to the worker not as per time he gives on the work, but the wages are given to the worker as per production he gives to the business. For example, there are two workers in a business. Both are giving 6 hours per day in the business or in the production, but one worker produces 50 items in a day and another worker produces 70 items or products in a day. In this way, the worker who is producing 70 products is paid more rate of wages in comparison to that worker who is producing 50 product. Here the wages are paid not according to time but according to product. For example, per unit wages is paid. If the per unit wages is paid 5 rupees each product, then if a worker produces 10 product in a day in 6 hours, he is paid 50. But if a worker produces 15 product in a day, then the wages will be 75. In this way, the wages are paid not according to time. They both are giving 6 hours. Worker A and worker B. If two worker are working, but the time is same, but the product is different, then the product wages are paid according to the number of product, not according to the time. This is called incentive waste system. Means more wages is paid to more efficient worker and less wages is paid to less efficient worker. This is called incentive wages or inspirative wages. In this way, the worker A is inspired to do more work so that he can get more wages. Okay, thank you.